The scene view is where we will visually build our game. In the top left, in the toolbar above the scene view, we can see the transform tools. The transform tools allow us to navigate within the scene and interact with the game objects in the scene view. Each of the five controls are mapped to the five keys at the top left of the keyboard. Q, W, E, R, and T. We can quickly swap between tools by using one of these hotkeys. The hand tool allows us to move around our scene. We can hold the left mouse button and drag to move. The next four buttons allow us to manipulate selected game objects in the scene. The translate tool allows us to move game objects along the X, Y, or Z axes. The handles on the tool correspond to each individual axis. Clicking on a handle and dragging with the mouse will allow us to move our game objects along one axis at a time. We can also click in the center of the tool and drag the mouse to move the game object freely along two axes at once. The rotate tool allows us to rotate our game objects. We can use the handles on the tool to rotate our game objects along the X, Y, or Z axes. By dragging the center of the tool, we can rotate the game object freely. The scale tool allows us to scale our game objects. Much like the rotate and translate tools, we can use the handles to scale our objects in size along the X, Y, or Z axes. We can again use the center of the tool, but in this case, this will scale the game object uniformly in all three axes at once. The Rect transform tool allows us to easily manipulate and size 2D and UI objects. This tool will allow us to translate, rotate, and scale a game object using one single tool. Although the Rect transform tool does work in 3D space with 3D game objects, it is best used when working with 2D or UI elements in your scene. This tool draws a box around the selected object and allows us to position, rotate, scale, and adjust anchor points of our 2D and UI objects. For more information on the Rect transform tool, see the UI lessons linked below. We can move around in our scene at any time without switching back to the hand tool. With any of the transform tools selected, holding the Alt and Control key on Windows, or Alt and Command key on Mac, we can invoke the hand tool and drag to move in our scene. Holding down the right mouse button at any time over the scene view will switch the editor into fly-through mode. In fly-through mode, we can use the W, A, S, and D keys to move, and the Q and E keys to change our height. It is worth noting that as we move in fly-through mode, we will continue to accelerate while any of the movement keys are held down. With any of the transform tools selected, if we hold Alt and the left mouse button, we can drag to rotate around our current point of focus. If we hold Alt with the right mouse button, we can drag to zoom in and out. The scene gizmo displays the scene view camera's current orientation in the scene and allows us to quickly modify the viewing angle and projection mode of the scene view camera. The scene gizmo allows us to quickly and easily switch between camera views by clicking on the various toggles on the gizmo. To switch between a 3D perspective view and an isometric view, simply click on the white cube in the center of the gizmo. Alternatively, we can also click on the title underneath the gizmo to toggle back and forth between view modes. Next to the transform tools are the two transform gizmo toggles. These toggles set where our transform tool gizmos will be placed in the scene compared to the game object selected, and how the selected game object will be affected by the current transform tool. The center pivot toggle defines where our transform tool's gizmo will be placed. In pivot mode, the transform tool will be placed at the pivot point of the selected game object's mesh. In center mode, the gizmo will be placed at the center of the bounding box of the current selection. This makes a significant difference if we have selected more than one game object. The local and global toggles define whether or not the transform tools will relate to global space or the object's current local space compared to its parent. To quickly frame the scene view on a game object in the scene, we can use Frame Selected. To frame the scene view on a game object, select a game object in the scene view and choose Edit, Frame Selected. Alternatively, we can simply press the F key on our keyboard when a game object is selected and the cursor is over the scene view. A game object can also be framed in the scene view from within the hierarchy window by double-clicking on a game object's name in the hierarchy list. In the upper left of the scene view is the scene view control bar. The first item in the scene view control bar is the draw mode menu. The draw mode menu allows us to change the draw mode for the scene view. The draw mode controls how the scene appears and what information will be shown graphically in the scene view. The draw mode can be changed from the default shaded view, the view our players will see when the game is running, to a wireframe view or a hybrid draw mode. The wireframe view and the hybrid view help us see detailed information about the mesh geometry. It's also possible to use the draw mode menu to view other detailed information about the scene in a graphical way. For more information on the draw mode drop-down menu and what it can do for your scene, please see the information linked below. The 2D toggle allows us to easily switch between a 2D and 3D view of our scene. The 2D view is most useful when working with UI elements, or if we're creating a 2D game. The lighting toggle defines whether or not the scene view uses the lights in our scene or default global lighting. This is helpful because it allows us to see how our lighting and shadows will look as we make changes to our scene. The audio toggle enables or disables audio effects on the scene view camera. The effects toggle button enables or disables all rendering effects in the scene view. We can also toggle individual effects on and off by using the drop-down menu beside the toggle. On the far right of the scene view control bar, we have our gizmo menu. Gizmos help us better identify our game objects, inform us how they are working in our scene, and can show us what components they have attached. Some gizmos help us identify game objects in the scene view by tagging them with icons such as lights, cameras, and audio sources. It is worth noting that some gizmos are only drawn when a game object is selected. The gizmo menu also allows us to customize the gizmos within our scene. When icon gizmos are in 2D mode, they are of a fixed size in the scene view. When 3D gizmos are enabled, their size can be adjusted using the size slider. The scene grid, the selection outline, and the selection wire are also gizmos, and they can be toggled individually from the gizmo menu. At the bottom of the gizmos menu is a toggle list of all of the available gizmos, allowing us to specify which gizmos are showing and which are hidden. The most recently changed gizmos will be sorted to the top of this menu for ease of editing. It is also worth noting that our own scripts can draw their own custom gizmos. For more information on creating your own custom gizmos, see the information linked below. The last part of the scene view control bar is the search field. The search field allows us to quickly search for and find different game objects or their components within our scene. Searching for an item highlights any game object in the scene view whose name matches the search criteria. Alternatively, we can search for any game object that contains a component whose type matches the search criteria. It's worth noting that this search filters both the scene view and the hierarchy window, showing only the matching game objects in both windows. So, as we can see, it is easy to navigate, locate, and manipulate game objects in the scene view.